Dear friends, greetings. When I travel in the aeroplane, I always wonder at the cosmos. I wonder as if I am part of the whole universe. Whenever we think about the universe, it is something fascinating. We are living one among the billions of the people on earth. The land we live is one part of the earth. And our earth is a small planet. It is going around the great planet Sun. And our Sun is a small planet in the great galaxy, Milky Way. There are billions of galaxies in the universe. When I think about that, I really wonder. I am the part of great universe. Everything is connected. Without them, I cannot live. Everything contributes for my living. This thought is something wonderful. I am not alone. I am not isolated. I am in a great part of the universe. But when we see the working of the universe, we see the nature having its own rule, its own limitations. Everything is going on in its way. But only the human beings are different. Human beings are the culmination of nature. We have creativity. We have the sense of wonder. We have freedom. And we are different from all the nature. We have our own nature. We have a life of grace, I call it. We have a life of grace. We have to be connecting ourselves with the whole universe. We have to be connecting ourselves with other human beings. We have to be connecting ourselves with the God who is running the whole show. When I think about the movements of the stars and everything that is happening in the universe, it is a reality show. I wonder at the reality. This time, I think about Jesus. Jesus is the one who connected himself beautifully with nature, in a wonderful way with God. For example, let us take his baptism. In the baptism, we see all the realities coming together. There is a cosmic union in his baptism. The fire is coming from high. The heavens are opened. And we have water, water of Jordan. And we have wind, the voice of God coming through the wind. We have dove. The whole universe is uniting in his baptism. He is united with the whole universe, whole cosmos. Through this connection, he understands the purpose of his life. He realizes the role he has to do in the whole cosmos. He has to respond to this unconditional love of God revealed in nature. And also, I could see the same cosmic union in the time of his crucifixion. While he was hanging on the cross, while he was giving away his spirit, we could see the cosmic reaction. The whole sky is darkened, and we see the trembling of the universe, earthquake, and so many other extraordinary events in that the moment of his dying. And also I see that the time of his resurrection, the time of his resurrection, everything comes together. And the stone, the grave goes away. And people see light when he is risen. And there is peace, not only with the people, in the whole universe there is a peace. Dear sisters and brothers and friends, we are called to be connected with the whole universe. The universe gives us purpose for our own life. We are unique. We have a particular purpose in life. And the life of grace we are living leads us to our own purposefulness, our own uniqueness, our own harmony with the whole creation. This is a beautiful thought when I realize, when I go on big travels, the cosmos is ours. We are not isolated human beings. We are part of the great universe. Thank you.